Naomi Osaka, fresh off of her Women Athlete of the Year award from the ESPYs. I kind of really want to do a deep dive into her life of who she is. Because like I said, I tell myself her and Simone Biles is the women athletes of our time. Just like how Serena Williams is still of our time. But these other two young African-American, well, she's African-American, Japanese ladies, but it's nevertheless, she's African-American. And seeing how they're coming up in today's society of taking that helm of being just our women athletes of our time. So I want to check this out.
No one really knows all the sacrifices that you make just to be good.
Before I won US Open,
so many people told my dad that I would never be anything.
Naomi, she was like an overnight superstar.
And I think that pressure weighed heavily on her.
I think the amount of attention that I get is kind of ridiculous. No one prepares you for that.
I don't know. I feel like I'm struggling.
She's young.
Everyone has an opinion. Her sponsors, her family, social media, you want to add in like another million people.
Growing up,
all I was thinking is like, I want my mom to like be happy. I want her to stop working. She would work overtime. She would sleep in her car.
And for me, that was my whole point of playing tennis. My dad's always been proud of where he comes from. Whenever I'm in hard situations, he's always told me my ancestors were on the ship for like 40 days. I use that as strength. I always had this pressure to maintain the squeaky image. But now I don't care what anyone has to say.
None of these deaths have to happen, and I just want everyone to know the names.
We learn every day. Living by example is the best we can do for our community, for our kids.
For so long, I've tied winning to my worth as a person. To anyone that would know me, they know me for being a tennis player. So, like, what am I if I'm not a good tennis player?
I am definitely here for this because that's, you know, I really want to take a deep dive into her life. And she is one of many athletes that have to figure out who they are in life. You know what I'm saying? Because you worked since you were a small child into this phenom that you became a success overnight. And you're young, so you don't really know how to deal with it. No one prepares you for it. They just tell you to go into where you're so busy and you're going all of the time. You know what I'm saying? That's why I've been watching the Simone Biles on Facebook Watch. And now I can't wait to watch this because when you're young with that level of success, they tie you in into successful because you're winning. But just like how Naomi just said it, well, it goes hand in hand. What happens if I'm, you know, not good anymore? What are you going to think of me then? And everyone's going to have an opinion. Oh, you fell off. Oh, you know. But it's just, no, you're retiring. That's why I look at Simone Biles like, this is my last one because, you know, you kind of just want to be normal. Like, I did everything I need to do to make the money I need to make. I'm good. And afterwards, in your lifetime, you know, you establish yourself as a coach or you establish yourself as a person, an individual, instead of a product that they have to sell. You know, because when you work so hard your whole life, especially in sports, they market you as a product. Now you're a product instead of a person. You know what I'm saying? So I can't wait to see how she's navigating herself through all this. And I love the fact that she is one of the first athletes that really said, hey, look, I need to take a break because of my mental health. Because that is becoming very, very relevant in how people deal with some of these things. Because over the past, you know, decades, it was always mask it, shut up, just keep it. But it's like, no, man, because, you know, I get it, because we're having so much information available to us. A lot of people are more sensitive nowadays, and because of these touchy subjects that we have to talk about. And it's weighing heavy on our generation, because it's like, damn, we have to carry the baggage for all of our parents, grandparents, of just shut up and just do it. And it's like, no, I'm taking a stand. Let's talk about these things. So that's the only way for us to move forward, is to understand the information. So I'm really here for this. And I can't wait to watch it. So you guys enjoyed my reaction to Naomi Osaka's official trailer coming to Netflix July 16th. Subscribe to my channel. Post comment down below and like the video. It's your boy, D. Dyson. Peace.